You talk about the future. Another thing that's inevitable about the future all over this country is changing demography.
Right.
You mentioned my opportunity to sit with the president. One of the things we talked about is the fact if you're going to have a digital age and you're going to put the burdens of changing the public's attitudes about these big issues and getting people more engaged from a civic participation standpoint, if you're going to have a digital age, everybody has to be in the digital
right.
age. One of the things we know, Mr. Case, is that whether it's the Internet of Things or the Internet of Everything, a lot of non-white people and a lot of poor people in this country don't have access to the same tools and the same devices as the rest of us do.
Correct.
How do we change that in order to enable the thing you're talking
about? It's very important. Even in that first way, we had a big initiative at AOL that trying to bridge the digital divide, because
right.
we're actually quite concerned as people had access to PCs, got connected to the Internet, but not everybody could get access or
right.
get connected. How does that exacerbate a divide that already existed? So we built 1,000 technology centers to try to bridge that. That will be, again, a problem in the third wave, but it's also an opportunity. Because
right.
in the second wave, as you allude to, I mean, there's most of the innovation came from a few places, and a particularly unique type of person, which is basically like white guys who went to good schools.
Yep.
In the third wave, there's an opportunity for much more inclusiveness, much more diversity of entrepreneurship, and the
yep.
people closest to these ideas, closest to the problems, are likely to be coming up with a better solution. So things like what Congress did pass, actually, a few years ago, with the support of the president, called the Jumpstarting Our Business Startups Act, the Jobs Act, legalized crowdfunding, which is a game changer in
yep.
terms of giving every entrepreneur an idea, the ability to get the initial capital to get started or to scale up. But right now, it's not fair. People, you know, Mark Zuckerberg happened to be at Harvard when he came up with the idea of Facebook, and he happened to have a rich friend across the hall, and so he could take that idea and run with it. But
right.
most people
don't
go to Harvard, and most people
right.
don't have a rich friend. And I think in the third way, we need to make sure we have
yeah.
a bias towards inclusiveness so everybody has opportunity.
Whose responsibility is it to solve that problem? Is it government? Is it business? I mean, you could argue that the technology sector, innovators themselves who have products to peddle, who have devices to sell, would do well to seed their own customer base on the front end by enabling this access. I mean, it'd be nice if government put a bunch of initiatives in place, but again, people become suspicious every
sure.
time government does that.
I think
so
it's
maybe it's on people like you.
It's a mix. It's
yeah.
a mix. And I think some companies, to their credit, like a Facebook, has an initiative to try to provide access to people who don't have internet access all around the world. Google's made a big investment in what they call Google for Entrepreneurs, trying to help inspire
right.
the next generation of entrepreneurs with a bias towards more inclusiveness, more diversity. So some folks are doing it, but not enough. I think that in this third wave, the innovators, the leaders of these companies really need to recognize it's not just about their company and maximizing profits. It's about the country or the society more broadly, and
right.
also maximizing purpose.